What the hell am I supposed to do here? It might be a trap. I had better be careful. This is the old Pico power station. I thought it was abandoned. Electrical condensers. Going by the sound of them, they're still active. A butterfly on the door. That's where I need to get to. I should never have got into this pipe. Glass. Broken glass. Sharp as a razor. Impossible to go back. I'm gonna have to crawl through it, slowly, so I don't tear up my arms. Match flame. It indicates where the fresh air comes from. All I have to do is follow the wind. Thank you. I guess I don't really have any choice. Keep it together, Ethan. Come on. Thank you.
Oh my. Ethan. Ethan, can you hear me?
Calm down, girl. There must be. Are those burn marks on your chest? You've got a hell of a fever. I'm gonna have to get your clothes off to disinfect those wounds. Those are serious burns. I don't know if I can do anything for you. Doctor, but I'll do what I can. Crap. That's disinfectant. Not terribly good for burns. Your wounds are disinfected. That should ease the pain. That's all I can do. How do you feel? Ethan?
He's unconscious. Now I'll just have to wait. And hope he wakes up.
How do you feel?
I've been better. Was I out for long?
About 3 hours.
Why the Guardian Angel Act? You don't even know me.
You didn't really leave me any choice. I couldn't just leave you like that.
You said you were here because you're an insomniac?
I've been going through a bit of a tough patch the last few months. The kind of stuff you prefer to forget. I do what I can to live with it, but it's not easy. That's the second time I found you in a bad way. You always seem to be running for your life. What's happening, Ethan? I'm sorry. I shouldn't be asking you questions. I mean, after all, we hardly know each other. You have no reason to trust me.
Listen, I'm truly grateful for your help, but for your own sake, I think it's better if you don't ask any questions.
Maybe I could help you.
No one can help me. You've already done a lot, Madison.
Right. I'm gonna go. Take care.
I didn't do it. I swear I didn't do it. I've got nothing to do with that business. I never killed nobody.
Oh, no? Then why did you run away when they came to question you?
I already told you. I forgot to report to my parole officer. I didn't want to go back to prison. When I saw the cops, I just bolted. I wasn't thinking straight.
We checked out his statement. He has an alibi for at least 3 of the murders.
Fuck, that bastard was a perfect fit. Shit!
Ash? Okay. Sean Moss's mother's here. She'd like to speak with you.
It was a few months back, the middle of the night. It was pouring down. Ethan came home completely drenched at about 3. I asked him where he'd been. He spoke about drowning, the rain. He didn't make any sense. There was something. Something in his eyes. As if it wasn't really him. There may be no connection, but the next day there was that announcement about another victim of the origami killer. Find my son. I'm begging you.
Police Lieutenant Carter Blake, and this is Agent Norman Jaden of the FBI. According to our information, Ethan Mars is one of your patients. We'd like to ask you a few questions about him.
I'm sorry, that's impossible.
I beg your pardon?
I'm bound by an oath of secrecy. Under no circumstances may I discuss my patients.
My job is to find Sean Mars alive, and I don't give a damn about any bullshit oath.
It's your duty to inform the police if you suspect one of your patients, Doctor.
I'm sorry. I can't help you. And now I must ask you to leave.
You need to cooperate. For your own sake.
He's right. Legally, you gotta tell us what you know.
Are you threatening me?
I'm just giving you some free advice, Doc. I suggest you take it.
I am going to call the police and make a complaint about your behavior.
Doctor, you are really pushing my buttons. The only thing I'm interested in is saving that kid's life. So, you're going to be a good boy and tell me what I want to know, or I am really going to lose my temper.
Child's life is at stake. You may know something that can help us save...
Let go of me. You have no right...
Come on, Doc. There's an easy way and a hard way. It's your fucking choice. If you don't let go of this man immediately, I'll report you and you'll be off the case. What the hell's the matter with you, Norman? Were you getting cold feet? You don't want to save Sean Mars anymore?
I want to save Sean Mars just as much as you do, but that doesn't give me all rights. So you're gonna stop this shit right now!
Ethan Mars has had psychological problems since his first son died. Feels responsible for his death. A sort of morbid neurosis. He is haunted by visions of drowning bodies. A few weeks ago, after one of our usual sessions, I found this on the floor. It must have fallen out of his pocket.
I want you to assign every available man to finding Ethan Mars. I want a man outside his place day and night. Notify all agencies to start looking for him. I want you to keep an eye on the train stations, the airports, the bus terminals. I want every cop in the city on his ass, so that if he moves, we know about it. Yes, Ethan Mars is the origami killer. Thank you.
kept Lauren in the dark on this one. I'll pick her up from her place later on.
Nice shot.
Thank you. Please come in, Mr. Shelby. Would you care for a coffee?
Oh, no thanks.
Do you play?
I tried once, but I think the owner of the course is still looking for me.
It's an interesting sport. It requires strength, but also a cool head and absolute precision. Would you care to hit a few balls with me? There's no danger of damaging the greens here.
Okay.
Take off your jacket and grab a club. The balls are in that basket. The most important thing is to grip the club correctly. When you feel ready, you swing. Well, it's only your first ball. You should try to strike it a little harder next time.
I'm assuming you didn't invite me here just to play golf, Mr. Kramer.
I hear you've been asking questions about my son.
That's right. I want to know if Gordy is linked to the Origami Killer case in any way.
My son had nothing to do with that sordid case.
Well, then he has nothing to fear from my investigation.
You have no business investigating my son. I told you, he had nothing to do with it.
With all due respect, Mr. Kramer, it's up to me to decide who I want to investigate.
I'm an influential man, Mr. Shelby, and I pay very well for loyalty.
Are you trying to buy me?
Let's just say I'm trying to show you where your interest lies. How much do you want to leave my son alone?
I think you misunderstood me. I don't play that game.
Don't go near my son, Mr. Shelby. If you do, you'll regret it.
Have a nice day, Mr. Kramer.
porcelain lizards? They look new, out of place with the rest of this old beat-up stuff.
Are you prepared to suffer to save your son? You have 5 minutes to cut off the last section of one of your fingers in front of the camera. If you succeed, you will get your reward.
Thank you.
You have 3 minutes and 30 seconds left.
That's affirmative, Lieutenant. We're in position.
Perfect. Nobody moves until I give this signal. Is that clear? We nail him as soon as he sets foot outside.
Right, Lieutenant.
Lucky that patrol spotted his car.
What's he doing in there?
Beats me. You're the profiler, right? I thought you were supposed to be right inside the killer's head.
Well, that's just it. What I know of Ethan Mars doesn't match the killer's psychological profile.
I know what the jury's gonna choose between your theories and concrete proof. What's that girl doing there? Marsh comes out now, she's gonna be in trouble.
What do we do, Lieutenant? Wanna get her out?
No, stand down. Going inside. Maybe she lives there. That's just as well. We don't want anyone hanging around if Mars comes out.
Ethan, what happened? The police. They're out there. I think they're here to arrest you. We've got to find another way out.
Shit. What's he up to in there? Wait for a go on my word.
They're still out there. We've got to find another way. Come on, think of something. Think of something fast.
On my go. Stay here, Jason.
Out of the question. I'm coming with you.
Two men at the door, hold your positions. It's a go.
Come on, let's go this way.
Thank you. up or I'll shoot!
Less than an hour ago, we heard from the police who have identified the man thought to be the Origami Killer. Ethan Mars, father of the kidnapped victim Sean Mars, is on the run and should be considered armed and dangerous. A police manhunt is now underway, and they hope that they will soon be able to announce the apprehension of this dangerous lunatic.
I brought some food. I didn't know what you liked, so I brought some of everything. I hope that's okay.
I don't have an actual mic.
Any cops?
No, I think we lost them. The guy at the desk, though, he gives me the creeps. I don't trust him. You were all over the news reports, Ethan. Every cop in the country will be hunting you. They say you're the Origami Killer. Is it true? Are you the killer, Ethan?
Absolutely not. Why would I be the killer? Confide? Oh, wait, I didn't mean to do that. Oh, no.
I sometimes have these blackouts. Times where I don't know what I'm doing. As if I'm someone completely different. The only thing I remember afterwards is the bodies. The bodies in the water.
Yeah. Why are you hurt, Ethan? Why were you in that apartment?
I think my other self is testing my love for Sean. He wants to know if I love my son enough to save him. That means there's some part of me that knows where Sean is. But the only way to find him is to go through these trials.
Why can't you tell that to the police?
And tell them what? That I'm a schizophrenic who drowned his victims and has kidnapped his own son? They'd never let me go, and I have to stay free to save Sean. I have no choice. I'm his only chance.
I'm not speaking at the moment. That's why you can't hear me.
When Sean is out of danger, I'll turn myself in, but not until then.
Like I said, I don't have an actual mic, so it might be hard to pick up any voice.
You can't keep going like this. You're destroying yourself, Ethan.
Finding Sean is the only thing that matters.
There has to be another way.
There is no other way.
You don't understand. Time is running out. Sean will be dead in a few hours. I have no choice. Please, Madison, leave. Forget everything that's happened. There is nothing more you can do for me.
Oh, wait, I know what's coming up.
If you want to help me, leave. Leave me to do this on my own.
Alright, I'll try that. Settings, devices, audio, input. Is this too loud? Yep, here comes the scene. Alright, let's get this going. Oh wait, I guess it's not right now. Oh, I know what's gonna happen now. Good K-bar. Let's see what I gotta do next, I forget. Up next. Come on, K-Bar. Oh, didn't see that. Kinda sucked.
Your vodka, sir.
What were you listening to, K-Bar?
Thanks.
I'll take that vodka.
You look preoccupied, if you don't mind my saying so. Problems with the investigation?
Why does this remind me of the Shining scene, like?
Blake is convinced that Mars is the killer.
Not you. I thought there was some evidence to that effect.
That's true. But it just doesn't make sense. His psychological profile doesn't fit. Neither does the geolocalization. I can't see this father drowning 8 victims before kidnapping his own kid. Mars is not the Aragami killer. Let's stake my life on it.
Trap songs or...
Then who is?
I haven't the faintest fucking idea.
Oh,
maybe you should review the evidence in your possession.
That's just what I was thinking of doing.
Oh, one last thing, sir. You should be careful not to overindulge in you know what. It can be dangerous. Mm. Very dangerous.
Don't do drugs.
I'm trying to keep a handle on it, but that's difficult. It gets more and more difficult.
It'll end up killing you if you're not careful.
Listen to him.
That would be most unfortunate, sir.
How about I only talk during, like, gameplay footage itself, but, like, during cutscenes, I don't say anything. Could be death.
Well, well. Looks like there's something new. The video recording from near the park on the afternoon Sean Mars disappeared. I doubt there's anything on it, but you never know.
Alright. Analyze.
A Chevrolet model corresponding to its tire prints passed at 1602 heading for the park, when in the opposite direction at 1637. That could fit the time that Sean Mars disappeared. Could it be the killer's car? Ah, pity we can't see the driver's face.
Sorry.
The car was stolen. Let's see. A certain Jackson Neville was suspected of stealing it, but the charges were dropped. Not enough evidence.
Okay. Oh, this is way better than Connect will ever be. Oh, this is just the flower. The orchid. Another origami figure. No, this is gonna help me at all. So tired. So do I, Dan. I was never gonna wait. This is new.
Jackson Neville, a.k.a. Mad Jack, involved in several cases of buying and selling stolen vehicles.
Right.
Considered to be very dangerous.
Like, confronted at one point.
This guy might have provided the killer with a car. It's a pretty slim lead, but it's all I have right now.
Wait a minute, he's in the... Okay, I thought he was just in the bar. Yeah, you are tripping. You better go to the bathroom.
Oh, one last thing, sir. You should be careful not to overindulge in no more. It could be dangerous. Very dangerous.
Shit. It's coming. Tryptocaine. The tube is on the bedside table. All I need is to take some, and the pain will go away. I should resist. This is gonna kill me. I know I can resist. I just need to stay in control and do something until it goes away.
Playing as Churchill Love. right, Dan?
Manfred! Manfred! Anybody home? What was that meeting with Charles Kramer at the golf club really about? Why is he so worried about me investigating his son?
Right, I gotta focus on what she's touching right now, because that'll be important later.
No one in the store. Might be somebody in the back room.
All right, let me go check. Oh, there he is.
Hi there, Manfred.
Who is it? Reminds me of Henry Adams
Scott.
From Batman Arkham Knight.
Scott Shelby. Do you remember me?
Scott?
This is Scott. Oh, yes, of course. Well, good to see you. How long has it been?
Oh, about 10 years, I guess.
Oh, at my age, time means nothing anymore. I repair clocks, but I try to forget about time. How about you? Are you still with the police?
Oh, no, I quit. I'm a private investigator now. This is Lauren. She's a friend.
Hello.
Hello, young lady. Well, this calls for a celebration. I've just the thing. Wait there. I'm sure I saw a bottle of scotch around here somewhere.
All right, please keep your hands off everything.
Do an old man a favor, would you, Scott? Tell him to call back this afternoon.
Sure, no problem.
You go around the desk. You know how to pick it up? I guess so.
Hello? Yeah, this is Manfred's. He's not available right now. Could you call back later this afternoon? Thanks.
Anything. Let me see. What are you doing?
Nothing much changed here. Just the dust and the clocks tick.
Well, to old friends.
Indeed.
I'd like you to have a look at an envelope. I thought maybe you could tell me about the typewriter that was used to type the address on it.
Yeah.
It helps you actually show the letter.
Now, could you pass me the magnifying glass from behind the counter?
Oh, sure, I'll get it.
My eyes are beginning to fail me.
Behind what counter?
Thanks. Well, let's see what this envelope has to say for itself. The Royal Five. And yes, the shape of the T's and the F's is typical of that model. Produced between 1907 and 1924.
Before the war.
Yes. No doubt about it. It's a Royal Five.
Are there many places around that could prepare one of these?
I bought the company's entire stock of spare parts for a song in 64. Well, they were going to take them to the dumpster, so I got the lot. Now, anybody around here who has one that actually works has been to see me at one time or another.
Do you keep a record of all your clients?
Oh, yes, indeed. At least the ones who pay.
Any chance I could get a peek at that?
Yes, of course. I keep my account books in the office. If you're not in a hurry, I have a list of all the clients who ever bought a Royal Five or had one repaired.
Yeah, that would really help us out.
Delighted to help. Give me 2 minutes, and I'll be right back with the list.
Oh, I know.
You think the killer's been here?
If he has a 1920s typewriter, he may have needed Manfred's services to get it fixed. We'll know when we get the list.
What's that? I seem as clueless as Kmart right now.
Stop touching things. Oh my god.
Lauren thinks she's about to find the killer. I'm afraid she's going to be disappointed. It's been a while since Manfred went into his office. Let's take a look.
Wrong way again.
Hello?
Manfred!
Hello? Your call is locked, sir. A police car will be there in a few minutes. I need to know who you are, sir. Sir? Hello?
Was just before you.
Oh my god. He's dead. Oh god.
Scott? Oh my god.
What are you doing?
I'm calling the police.
Yeah, I
think the killer has already called the police. I think he wants us to be a scapegoat. We've got to get the hell out of here.
What do you mean? We have nothing to do with his death. We were just here when it happened.
Look, we're running out of time to find Sean Mars. The last thing we need is 24 hours in a police station explaining this whole thing.
Well, so what do we do?
Watch the front door. I'll get rid of our fingerprints from everything we touched since we came in. We better work fast. The police are going to be here any minute.
All right, you do that. I tried the corpse already, it's important. Come on.
will be here any second.
I'm almost finished. That's it. We're done.
You get all the prints?
Hang tight. I'll just check one last time. I haven't forgotten anything.
We're fine.
That's it. We're done.
You get all the prints?
Yeah. Oops, sorry.
I got what I got. It should be enough to prevent them from fighting us. Come on, let's go.
I feel like I just feel like...
I'm taking you home. This is getting way too dangerous.
No way. We're partners,
yeah,
remember?
Man.
We had a deal.
It's nighttime right now. I don't want people upstairs to hear me.
Listen, Lauren, I know you want to find the killer, but you're not helping me by putting yourself in danger.
I'm not a child. I know what I have to do. I've got to find my son's killer. You're not going to stop me.
You're gonna be a good girl. You're gonna go home and let me get on with my investigation. Choice. I guess I'm doing this to protect her. It's all my fault. I should never have let her come with me. I can't just leave her like that. She'd do anything to find the guy who killed her son. Lauren!
To hold him once again in my arms.
Yeah, I apologize.
I'm sorry. I shouldn't have talked to you like that. It's just that I wouldn't want to see you get hurt.
That was a fun little segment right there. What do we have next? Ooh, Ethan Mars again. I gotta be really careful, because I think, yep, this is the scene. Gotta shoot somebody. Oh, I don't want to do this. But you know what, it's COD. So, Billy, if you're still up, Eli, sorry, enjoy. I have no cuts here.
Yeah? What do you want? Ugh, fuck you. I said 1,000 times that I don't want any junkies in my
car. I almost have to use my nose.
Hey! Take it easy, man. Huh? Keep cool. What do you want?
Yeah.
Dope?
Billy, definitely.
Money? Tell me what you need. Sure we can make a deal, huh? Just you.
I'm gonna blow your brains out, you son of a bitch! You think you can come into my house and steal my gold? You're gonna be shooting up here!
drop it.
Hold it, man. I give you whatever you want. Got dope? I got cash?
Yes, Ashley was the idea.
You want some dope? Please.
She's asleep.
Please don't kill her.
Whatever. And she's probably not going to come back from the stream.
I got children. These are my girls, see? This one's Sarah.
Oh, hey,
Kayla. And the little one.
This is just a little bit of Todd mixed in.
Please, man. I want to see them again. Please. Please don't shoot.
Do you think this guy was actually telling the truth?
I'm a father, too.
I'm sorry.
But I have no choice.
Oh, that's great. Yeah, throw up everywhere and leave your DNA lying all over the place. That'll go great with the cops. At least you didn't get bruised up or anything, though. You just had to shoot somebody. Mentally, that scarred him, but physically, he's all good. In the gun grip. Again! Why? I wish the game just let us check there before. You gonna play some COD, Billy? Alright, take care, man. Are you going to be streaming it? This is great. Now I don't have to, like, type into my phone or anything. I know it's Roosevelt. That's like the only part of the address I know. Poor guy. Kids also for them. Madison, waifu, Maddie Moo. Not really my waifu. Where are...
Matt, it's Sam. I got your information.
Oh,
and the owner
no.
of the apartment in Marble Street
God.
Is Dr. Adrian Baker.
Wish me luck,
He's a stock-off surgeon. They used to sell drugs to junkies on the quad. He made some cash and bought up some cheap-ass apartments, including the one in Marble Street. Of course, he got caught. He did a few months in prison and was struck off the medical register.
Interesting. Thanks for the information, Sam. I owe you one.
Hey, Matt, be careful, okay?
I'm on it. Talk to you later.
Hopefully there's later. Waifu hype. Yeah, this waifu needs to prove herself.
The owner of the apartment where Ethan cut off his finger lives here. It's not much of a lead, but it's all I've got.
I wish they would explain how she found out, but you know what? That's not important. Time to regret our decisions instantly.
Hi. I was told that you could get Bitropin.
What?
Would that a prescription?
Sorry, you were misinformed. Goodbye.
Take a
Hold
look
on.
At Dan, who does he remind you of?
I really need your help here. I can pay.
Well, why didn't you say?
I think I know what to do, Dan. I've seen Please plenty of videos from this. It's the Mad Jack thing coming up later on that I'm a little shaky on.
So, you're looking for Bitropin, my dear. Are you having trouble sleeping? How much do you need?
I don't know, about 3-4 boxes.
three or four boxes? How much
should be a problem? Would you like a drink? I was just about to have one.
No, absolutely
no,
not.
No, thanks.
Well, alcohol helps take the edge off the pills, don't you think? Anyway, we should drink a toast to our first deal.
No, no, no. I don't want to accept your hospitality. Imagine if I was playing this blind, though. I'd probably accept this drink, but I know what's supposed to happen.
I haven't seen you around here before. Who told you about me?
Evade?
The important thing is that we're here, right?
Apartment.
I heard you had some apartments for rent.
Excuse me.
I'm looking.
Sorry, darling. Those are all booked
up. He really is creepy. I'm trying to see if I
Shame.
Can... If he reminds me of anybody.
I was looking for something around Marble Street.
He knows it's Friday, though, because he's got that Hawaiian shirt on. Oh, yeah, by the way, Marble Street.
You're not drinking?
No.
I'm not really thirsty.
Not thirsty whatsoever.
I'll get your prescription. Won't be a moment. Wait here.
I'd rather leave right now.
That guy gives me the creeps.
Uh-huh.
I better take a look around to see if I can find anything before he gets back.
Yep. I don't know if I can avoid the scene coming up, but I'm gonna try. Check his drawers. Or not. Okay. Bedside table. That's all we need. That's all we need. Get out of there now. Oh, come on, please. Come on, go. Leave. Ayo. I dodged the bullet. That was hype. I did good. Yeah, smart girl indeed. That's the trophy I just got. Well, not smart, just pulling it up. And this is Mad Jack. Okay.
Great.
Gotta be careful. I am considering taking a trip though here. I'm really considering it, but I don't know if I can use it. Let's see. Alright. Check out the man jack here. Come through. Go to him.
Can you stop that thing?
It looks like somebody your size, Dan. Why don't you take a fight with them?
Norman Jaden, FBI. Can we talk for a minute?
I'm listening.
Can we go inside?
Yeah. I feel like he's taking stuff away from us, but... Here he is with the... That's why it's called Mad Jack.
I'm looking for the owner of a blue Chevrolet Malibu 83. I don't give a damn how the car got here, whether you stole it or not. I just want to know who bought it from you.
Sorry, man. Don't ring a bell. I got a real bad memory.
Or Vander Holyfield.
Perhaps I can help you to remember. If we find out that you sold the car to the man we're looking for, you're looking at some pretty solid time inside, Jackie boy.
You trying to scam me with your big talk? I never saw your damn car. Gotta take a walk.
Maybe later. First, I'm gonna find out what you're up to. Sorry. Wish we had these today. This game was made in 2010.
Blood. Now, why is there blood here? The blood tracks lead to the acid bath.
Oh. There's the acid bath.
Size 10. Most likely a visitor. Fingerprints. Probably Matt Jack's.
All right.
Size 13. Must be Matt Jack's size. Same brand of tire as the car I'm looking for. Is the killer's car being here? Barry, comment. Traces of orchid pollen in the air inside the garage.
Getting close to something. To check out the aftermath. Not this way. No filter works. I'm gonna do something real quick. Gotta charge my phone up. And get the lights as well. Yep.
solder up his little mouth.
Oh, yeah. There goes the gun.
Hands on your head, pig. I ain't got time to be playing around with you. Let's just get you out of sight and finish you off.
You're gonna tell me about the man with the blue car.
Go fuck yourself in the ass. Damn! You out of your motherfucking mind, man?
Oh, shit, Jack. Ain't nothing to it. Just a little bit of self-defense. Page one of the police manual. Kill or be killed.
Whoa. Stop. Enough. I'm starting to remember some things. You be cool. I'll tell you the tale. No, I don't know nothing about the guy. He wanted me to get rid of his dirty car. Get him a new one with false plates. He paid cash, and I ain't the questioning kind. He said I was supposed to drop the word to a guy named Parker.
I really want to take
him. The car was done. Now that's all I know.
Parker.
We'll continue this discussion down at the station. You're under arrest. You have the right to remain silent. Anything...
Oh, I don't know if I can do this part.
Shit, not now. Anything you say can and will be.
Hey,
you look like you got a problem, man.
Just pick him. I took the drugs.
Turn around.
I took the drugs. I didn't actually mean to do that. Oh no. At least she lives. But I'm gonna get a different ending. I think I remember Coffee saying he took the drugs every time he played this. Shit. I did not mean to do that though, Dan. I'm sorry.
You think the origami killer killed Manfred?
That makes sense. Didn't want him spilling his guts to us.
And you suspect Gordy Kramer, right?
Oh, him or one of his men. Gordy has the time and the means, not to mention the fucked up attitude to go along with it. Mm-hmm. He's only a suspect, but he's a pretty guilty looking one.
Are these your files on the case?
Yeah, I've been working on them for a couple years. I build up a mountain of paperwork.
Magazines about origami? Do you think the killer could have subscribed to one of those?
If he was even remotely interested in origami in the last 30 years, his name may be in there somewhere. Trouble is, there's over 500 names. It gets a squat.
I'm starving. Do you have anything to eat?
Well, I'm no chef, but I should be able to make some scrambled eggs if you like.
Great. I'm soaking wet.
Scrambled.
I need to warm up a little.
Do that.
Is it okay if I take a shower?
Yes, go take a shower.
Be my guest. Go to my bedroom. It's the next door. Oh, I'll cook up the eggs while you're under the shower.
I cannot believe it. I didn't mean to. I thought, like, pressing those commands would make me actually calm. The game doesn't do a very good job of telling you that. I didn't know if he was going to actually go for it. And it's not like I can, like, restart. Oh yeah, those eggs do look pretty big. Alright, scramble them up. That looks like shit. Oh, wrong way. Yeah. I wouldn't feed that to Churchill. Would you feed this to Churchill? Like, those don't look good.
It should be ready by now.
Alright, turn off the oven. I can't hear it. There you go. I like how it just plop out onto the dish. Mmm. Yummy.
I took the liberty of borrowing your bathrobe.
Looks better on you.
Hey, what? That almost looks good enough to eat.
What's that?
The notebook I took from Manfred's place. According to this, about 30 clients bought spare parts for Royal Machines in the last 10 years. The killer may be one of them.
Oh, you know, checking out the alibi of 30 clients one by one, that's a lot of legwork.
Except that if we cross-check them with the list. The list of subscribers to Origami magazines. You still got that, right?
Yeah. Lauren, wait.
She has something.
If the killer really used a Royal typewriter, and if he subscribed to an Origami magazine, his name should be on both lists.
Well, Lauren, I mean, that's just an assumption, but yeah, I suppose.
His name is here somewhere. Help me. We're gonna find him.
Epic montage. Get over the drug scene. That's gonna bite.
The only guy whose name was on both lists died when he was 10. What are you gonna do now? Pick up his coffin, make sure he's dead?
I know it doesn't make any sense. Unless the killer was only using his name.
But why use the name of a kid who died 30 years ago?
Well, that's what we came to find out. The name is John Shepherd. It should be on a grave around here somewhere.
You never give up, do you?
Go find a grave. What you thinking about, Dan?
Shepherd's grave must be somewhere around here.
Did anyone ever tell you you shouldn't shout in the cemetery?
Take it easy. The dead don't mind.
Oh, damn. Disrespecting the dead. Where is she? Here.
Excuse me. I'm looking for the grave of a young boy who died about 30 years ago. His name was John Shepherd. You wouldn't know where it is by any chance.
The children's graves are in the next plot.
Thanks.
Needle woman. I guess not, that's fine.
Excuse me, I'm looking for... Well, don't worry about it. I can manage alone.
I guess so too, Dan.
Looks like someone's still tending the grave. Origami figures.
That's one hell of a coincidence.
Dan, wait.
Oh, youngin'. That one I knew well.
You knew John Shepherd?
I've worked this graveyard nearly all my life. I remember what happened. It was in 77, October, I think.
Yeah, good for nothing, hoodlum. Get the hell out of here. God, beat it, you lousy, no good brats. Come back when your fucking mother comes home from work.
He's drunk again.
Oh, yeah, what are we gonna do? It's pouring rain. We're gonna get soaked if we spend a day outside.
Well, at least you won't get beat. A little rain never hurt nobody. Come on, let's go play.
I remember this game well.
Bet you can't catch me!
I find it sad that their play areas are just this abandoned construction site.
Dan someplace to live.
Come on!
I'd probably be terrified right now. In fact, I'd probably be able to hold myself up. That must really hurt your hand. Go down. Please control sometimes, I swear. I hate how you have to hold down.
I can do it all right. Just watch.
What the heck?
And count to 20 and try to find me, okay? One, two, three, four, five, nine, 13, dog.
Who would think the Sonic OVA movie?
I'll throw this.
Kid never did find any help. Yet his brother drowned in 5 foot of rainwater.
The boy that lived, what happened to him?
Well, all I know is he got separated from his parents. I think he got adopted. Well, looks like a storm's coming. I guess I better be getting home.
Storm's coming. It's been raining all day. And, like,
Christ, what a horrible story. John Shepherd drowned in the rain while holding his brother's hand. Do you think he could be the origami killer?
Come on. Let's get back in the car.
But I'm also a realist. Shepherd is gone. And, yeah, I'm not going to spoil anything.
Shepherd's grave.
Madison. Oh, is this where we go? Hit up the club? Think it is. Yep, blue again. I got what I needed. I didn't have to battle the guy.
Paco Mendez. He's the guy who rented the Doc's apartment on Margo Street. Better be careful. He might be the killer. I could catch his attention by spreading the stuff. Girl.
Lucky day, sweetheart. The boss wants to invite you to his table.
Hey, thanks for accepting my little invitation. You know around here,
I don't like this guy.
I think I would have noticed you before. My name's Paco. Are you?
Madison. I'm Madison.
Ah, I Hey, you move, Mari, son. You making me all hot under the collar.
Maybe we can continue this just conversation like you, somewhere more private.
Oh, cool, baby. Yeah, come with me.
Get into big trouble. Everything's gonna be all right. Everything is going to be all right.
That doesn't make sense. But you know what? I'm on a question.
So, welcome to my little kingdom.
Oh, God. I know what happens now. I remember.
I'll take it. Just get in the way. So, show me what you can do. Take it all. Slowly. Take it all off.
Speak?
Could we just talk first?
We don't need any more talking, baby. I all talked out.
Yeah, small talk. Baby.
Show me what you can do.
Like, talk more. I don't know. I know there's no way I can do this.
Could I have a drink? You know, just a little drink to break the ice?
You already broke the ice. Let's get wet.
Oh, God.
Do your thing, girl.
I'm sorry. I think there's been a little misunderstanding. I'll just go. No harm done. Another time.
I think it is you who are misunderstood, honey. I'm tired of wasting my time. It's now or never.
You just shoot somebody in the girl party from the center.
But you go, girl. Okay, act two. Let's hear Lover Boy sing.
Ah! Hey, Dan, I just noticed you're back. Part is really weird.
If you call out, I'll kill you. Got it?
Shit. What you want?
You rent an apartment on Marble Street. I want to know why.
An apartment? I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, I think you do.
Fucking bitch! I'm gonna kill you! You haven't got the balls, lady. But you're gonna know balls when I catch up with you.
Oh, no. I'm so nasty.
Boss? Is everything all right?
Busy? I am dying right now with laughter. Look at his reaction.
If you value those prize balls of yours, Paco, then it's time for you to talk.
Oh, God. I don't want to do this.
What you doing? Stop it! Stop it!
I'm only getting started. How about
some more? The controller is even vibrating right now. Just like...
I never set foot in that apartment. I gave the keys to some guy. He said he needed a place. He had money.
What was that guy's name?
I might have to use...
I don't know his name. I swear. Shepard! His name is John Shepard! That's all I know, I swear it!
John Shepard, so now she knows too.
There, that wasn't so hard, was it? I really appreciated this romantic moment.
Dan,
but I gotta dash.
Because that was really, really good.
See you next time, lover boy.
But the good news is, I won't be getting time. Tell me about it.
Time to get out of here. I've got a massive headache.
Is Norm Jaden. But it's gonna be crazy. He's going to the same place.
I'm here to see Paco. Paco? There ain't no Paco here,
oh,
fella. Get lost. Are you absolutely certain? He's in his office. Take the stairs over there.
Scarpy, I gotta hear you come in. A crazy beast came around here asking questions about the apartment on Marble Street. I don't know what you're doing now, and I don't want to know. But whatever that shit is, it's beginning to draw attention. Look, I know you kept me out of prison. But that fucking beast nearly killed me. Everything you ask. I think my debt to you is paid. Don't fuck around, man. No. Now wait. I can still help you out. No. Don't keep me.
He's still in the apartment. room. Get open. I just got chills. Where is he? Yeah, you have the orange, but isn't he in the, yeah, he's right behind you. Holy shit. Oh boy.
Madison Page. What was a journalist doing here?
Okay.
Orchid pheromones. The fucking origami killer.
Why does he always have orchid pheromones on him?
A bullet. Right between the eyes. Instant death. Paco Mendez was no saint. His rap sheet reads like the telephone book.
Yeah, there's evidence.
The killer was looking for something.
What else we got? No, don't take off the R's, you dummy. Okay, I think I already just looked over it. He's a drug dealer. Oh, new clue. What is this? No. Check. No, don't leave either. Gotta check the gun. Not sure around it, just check the gun. Wrong way.
His coat pocket. I tore it off during the fight. Two receipts from the same gas station. Interesting.
Are you gonna go to that gas station? I probably should move. Again. Thank you.
45 caliber semi-automatic.
I have no idea what else to check. Tell us here, hang on. What is that? That must be the bullet shell.
45 caliber. Casing.
45 caliber.
Madison Page? She may be a witness.
Yeah, she is. That's just my own gun. Right. This is the way. Alright, I don't see anything else to use here. I think I'm gonna leave. Yeah. The gas station building, or the receiver, and, you know, it's going to be a little bit.
Gotta go. I'll end up a basket case if things keep going like this. That bastard nearly broke my neck. Got the shakes. Cold sweats. Let's get back to the hotel fast. Shit. Looks like a dead end. Road to nowhere. Paco knew the killer. That's why he was killed. He seems to spend most of my time getting the shit kicked out of me. It's too dark. It all happened so fast. Didn't have time to see his face.
We're moving on to Ethan. Guessing who's where are we? Oh man, poor guy.
Ethan, are you all right?
Yeah, he had to shoot someone.
I killed a man. I had no choice. I had no choice.
You're not the origami killer, Ethan. You're not responsible for those murders. I can prove it.
That changes nothing.
Saving Sean is all that matters now.
That is true. Better save him. Uh-oh. Do you think, Dan, should I do it? Should I just stare out?
I can't.
Let me... Hang on. Let me restart.